Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, you believe also in me.
On the outstand.
For in my Father's house,
in my home, shall be
are many mansions.
Forever.
If it were not so, I would have told you. Go to prepare a place for you. Yes.
I'm longing for you. And someday on the outstand.
For we know that all things work together. For the good of them that love the Lord. To them who are called according to his purpose. Who shall separate us from the love of God?
And someday,
nay, in all of these things we are more
on the outstand
than conquerors through him
my home
that love us.
Shall be forever.
For I am persuaded. Neither death, nor life, nor angels, principalities, nor power, things present or things to come, for God shall wipe all tears from eyes.
Sweet Beulah Land.
She's in Sweet Beulah Land now.
Beulah Land. Oh, Sweet Beulah Land.
Good night over here. She sleep with the angels now. Sleep with Jesus. Rest from all your weary and all your labor. Say goodbye over here.
Sweet Beulah Land.
But hello on the other side. Sleep on now. Take your rest. The Lord bless you today. We have gathered here today to remember and reflect on the life of that of Karen Valentine. Let the family know that we are lifting you up even now in prayer. And we pray that something is done today that will uplift your spirits during this time of bereavement. And along with the professional staff of Myers Mortuary Services, an outline has been provided. We will hear in our hearing an opening hymn of Amazing Grace. I will then return with the reading of the scripture and prayer. And after the prayer, I will come with further instructions. Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound. Is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valleys in the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod, thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The Old Testament reading was from Psalm 23. The New Testament will come from the Gospel of John. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, you believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye shall know. The New Testament reading, John 14, verses 1 through 3. May we bow our heads in prayer. Dear Jesus, I love you. You're a friend of mine. You supply my every need. My hungry soul you feed. I am aware that you are my source, from whom all blessings flow, my Lord. And God, with this in mind, I know just where to go. And so we come today boldly but yet humble before the throne of grace. We come in that name of Jesus. God, before we ask you for anything, we thank you for everything. For you said in your word, in all things give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. So we thank you for these years that you have allowed this loved one to impact the lives of those who are gathered today. This mother, this grandmother, this auntie, this friend. God, we thank you for the memories that the family will have in the days ahead, because it will be those memories that give them comfort, those memories of conversations and laughter that will strengthen them in the moments when their heads are bowed. And God, I ask you now to wrap your arms around this family. Let them know that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. And God, I even further pray that when the phone calls have ceased, the visitations are no more, will you remind this family of your word that said that I'll never leave you, neither would I forsake you. And God, when you do these things, we won't take any credit, but we'll say to God be the glory for the great things that you have done. It's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. Time has been allocated and carved out for moments of reflections and remarks. And I would ask that at the request and at the honor of the family, that those who are coming to limit your remarks to 2 minutes, you will come to the podium and share your reflections. And the floor is now open for those who will come to share in your remarks and reflections at this time.
Say thank you for everybody who came. This has been really hard for me. It's my mom, you know. I know she was a mom to me and Tamika, but she was, like I said, an auntie, a grandmother, a nana. She was a friend. And I just want to say that she was strong. She fought as hard as she could. I was just thankful that for as long as she could stay, that she did. And I just wanted to say that no matter who you were to her, she loved you, no matter what. Thank you.
I just want to say thank to everyone who showed their support, who could be here today, and those who couldn't be here today. I'm going to read a tribute that her brother sent, and it says, "To my little sister Karen, I wish I could hug you and just see your face, but now I have memories to stand in your place. Gone but not forgotten, that's what they say. Of course, that is true. But if only you could have stayed. The author of that was Catherine Lamberton. And it says, I miss you already. Love your big brother, Bobby. I'm going to read some of what I wrote in the tributes that's in the obituary. It says, Mom, even though your time here was shorter than expected, only God knows the reason why you had to leave so soon. And I trust him that you are in a better place and have all the happiness that your heart desires. Your memory will forever be in our hearts, as well as your laugh and smile. Even though you rarely let us take pictures, I will remember all the good times we had and was grateful that you were able to come here with me to South Carolina and spend time with me and the kids when we were here. Even though you favored the grandkids instead of the regular kids, because you were Nana, that was your proud name, Nana, Nana. You didn't want to be grandma, you want to stay young, Nana. But, you know, that's what Nanas do. Rest peacefully, we love you always. Gonna miss you. I just want to say thank you for choosing me. My mom, she had me when she was 15. Going on 16, and she could have chose any other choice, but she chose me. And I say thank you, because if you didn't make that choice, I wouldn't be here today. So I will forever and eternally thank you, and I will love you forever. I love you, Mom.
Trying to think of what to say, when you think about the people, you know, God places in your life. Well, first of all, Tamika came at a very, very precious, sentimental time in my life where everything changed. That's how our friendship started. And from there, she deployed, and I got a phone call one morning, and I didn't recognize the number at all. And I'm just like, so I answered it. And she was like, is this Missy? And I was like, yes. She said, Tamika left your number, and she said if I needed anything to call you. So I was like, I wanted to cuss, because I was like, damn, Tamika, like, dang. Could tell me, I ain't even know the whoop de whoop whoop de whoop. But from there, that's how I met her. And I had just got out of the Army, and I was trying to decide what to do with my life and do with myself. And I know I was real distraught at that time, and she was always, you know, she would get in the car, and the first thing she would ask me, can I smoke a cigarette in here? And at first I was like, man, I ain't with these cigarettes. But I let her smoke her cigarettes, because, I mean, I used to smoke cigarettes, you know. But at the same time, it was like, you know, and she would tell me some amazing things when she lit them cigarettes up. Like, but it was always things that kept me uplifted. And no matter, you know what I'm saying, what we started the day out with, we always had more at the end of when I dropped her off. And I mean, I'm not going to go too far in depth, but I really, really, really thank you, Ms. Karen, for all the advice that you gave me, you know, the things that we talked about in our lives, the mistakes that we make, how we can, you know, we can't always change the mistakes that we made, but we know each day that we get, we can make it better. And I want to thank you for that, and I want to thank you for your daughter. Thank you.
Caveat a little bit off of what Missy stated. My encounters with Miss Karen was similar. One of the things that I will tell you about Miss Karen is that Cinnamon was her pride and joy. She loved her Cameron. She loved her grandkids dearly. And she loved their children. As Missy said, she knew she didn't do right as she should have done by her children, but her grandchildren, she tried to make up for it. Miss Karen, she wasn't one to mix words. What she meant is what she said, and she was not going to change it. She was very direct and to the point, and there was no way for you to confuse what was coming out of her mouth. One of the last memories that I had of Miss Karen, I was actually picking her up from the hospital, and I was on my way to go pick Miss Karen up, but she called me and she said, before you come and pick me up, you need to go by the house and get my pocketbook and my cigarettes. I said, Miss Karen, you show your pocketbook and your cigarettes there? She said, yes. I went by the house and I searched up and down that house with them cigarettes. And it was where she said it was. It was in the bathroom. And I brought Miss Karen her pocketbook. The first thing she said when she said, these people got me sitting up here. She said, don't look at me, because I ain't cute right now. She said, I don't know why Tamika sent you to come pick me up, and I'm not cute right now. So she was very much about her appearance and how she looked and presented herself to people. But I know that she was very proud of you, Tamika, and I know that she didn't leave nothing behind that she felt was unfinished. She knew that whatever needed to happen, that you were able to take the baton and keep it running for her. Cinnamon, your mom was always proud of you, and she's going to consistently be proud. Even though she's not here, she's going to always be with you. And you have to always remember that. There's nothing that, God makes no mistakes. It was her time, and now is your time to continue on. And y'all just move forward, and I'll always be there for you, and I'm appreciative of you allowing me to share this time with you, Ms. Karen, even though this is your last moments, but trust, this isn't the end. Y'all keep it moving, okay?
Discouraged, and why should the shadows come? Why should my heart feel lonely and longing for heaven and home, when Jesus is, he's my portion. Oh yes, he does.
what a reminder that if God is watching over the sparrow, surely he'll look after his love for his children. Matthew 5 says, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. I want to share with you today briefly the comfort in knowing. The ironic thing about mourning is that it's a part of the circle of life. There is no way to escape the time of mourning. And according to Ecclesiastes 3, to everything there is a season, a time, to every purpose under the sun. And there's a list of things that is given in Ecclesiastes 3, and two of those things that are listed are a time to be born and a time to die. Also listed among that is a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. The only thing about this is that we have no clue, or we do not know the time when this will occur. What we do know is that these times are destined to occur at some point or some points in our life. But somehow there is something that the scripture tells us about mourning. And that is, in the time of mourning, we are blessed. As it says in our text, blessed are they that mourn. When you first hear that, it sounds oxymoronic because it seems to contradict itself. How can I be blessed when I am mourning? How can you put blessed and mourn in the same sentence and make it make sense? How can I be blessed while tears are in my eyes? How can I be blessed when the person whom I love is laying before me? Where is the blessing in having my heart torn away from me? How can I be blessed when things have drastically has been changed in an instant? Can I truly say that I'm blessed when I am in mourning? One of the most frustrating things in life is that not knowing the why, nor knowing the answer to that question. But the songwriter said, Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him, there is no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus gives us comfort in John 14 and 18. He said, I will not leave you comfortless. And during this time, when we're now the week of Thanksgiving, your first Thanksgiving without your dear nanny, Nana, the first Thanksgiving, first Christmas without your mother, how is it that you don't know? How is you going to feel when this time come and you look for mom to be there, she's not there? Jesus said, I will not leave you comfortless, for I am with you. He'll be a friend to the friendless. For the Bible said that God shall wipe all tears from your eyes. I will not tell you not to cry, because you will cry. But there's no need to worry what the night is going to bring, for it will be all over in the morning. I leave you with this, Fanny Crosby. She was a little girl who was blind from birth. She was not able to play freely and independently as her other friends. She had to rely on stick and had to rely on someone carrying her to her destination. But this blind little girl, Fanny Crosby, she wrote a poem that one day a musician put music to it. But the poem said, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. I am an heir of salvation, purchased by God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is the part I want to leave with you today. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Now, Lord, I pray that the words of my mouth the very meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. You are my strength. You are my redeemer. Be a lifter of their heads. God, comfort them, the grands. I pray now a special blessing and comfort over them as they have said goodbye to their precious nanny. I pray that the memories and the impartation will go with them far beyond into their adulthood, that they will look back and say, it's because this person had an impact in my life. I am who I am today. It's in your name I do pray. Jesus' name, amen. Ain't no need to worry. What the night is going to bring, it'll be all over in the morning. For as much has pleased the Almighty God in his wise providence to remove from this walk of life Karen Valentine, it becomes our duty to present her body, her remains unto the Lord, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, until the coming of the Lord in that great day when the trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise first. May we together say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide until we meet again in Jesus' name. Amen.
To Reverend Black and Mr. Jett, thank you so much for your participation on today's program. This family appreciates you. To this beautiful family, on behalf of our owner and director, Mr. Brian W. Myers, and our entire family here at Myers Mortuary, we want you to know that it has been our pleasure to serve you these past few days. We hope that something we have done has brought some level of comfort to you. We know that this has not been easy. We want you to know that we are here for you for whatever you may need. We are just a call away. God bless you.
Better when you smile, so smile.